How does one make that sound good?
I'm afraid that is not possible. That poem is the opposite of good. That poem's nonsense.
But I thought this sort of thing was supposed to be your pleasure.
Poetry, yes. Byron, heavens no.
Is not everyone supposed to love Byron?
Many in our year at Cambridge thought my poetry far superior to his.
Does that mean yours is more or less deceitful?
Deceitful? Poetry's the opposite, brother. It's the art of revealing precious truth with words.
Yeah, quite right, brother. You're being serious?
Mm-hmm.
Good God. Good night.
What is it truly to admire a woman?
To look at her and feel inspiration?
To delight in her beauty.
So much so that...
that all your defences crumble.
That you would willingly take on any pain.
Any burden for her.
To honour her being with your deeds and words.
I love you. I've loved you from the moment we raced each other in that park. I've loved you at every dance, on every walk, every time we've been together and every time we've been apart. You do not have to accept it, you do not have to embrace it, or even allow it, knowing you probably will not, but you must know it in your heart. You must feel it, because I do.
Obviously, something between you. And I know that this is not as you would wish it. But you must be honest with yourself. Because one way or another, these kind of feelings always have a way of coming to the surface.
What kind of feelings are those?
He was going to ask me to marry him. The Viscount.
And I could not allow it, Mama. He was going to ask me out of mere obligation, some misguided notion of duty after the two of us.
Do you think that there is a corner of this earth that you could travel to, far away, to free me from this torment? I am a gentleman. My father raised me to act with honor, but that honor is hanging by a thread that grows more precarious with every moment I spend in your presence. You are the bane of my existence. You
like a song I heard when I was young.
And the object of all my desires.
That is what the true poet describes.